will be deliberating upon today on writing an article and research article. I hope our master degree students in the final year have to write dissertation. Our MPhil scholars have to get the supervisors to work on article and research article and also write their thesis. Our PhD scholars have been continuously working on writing research writing with the help of their respective honorable supervisors. So this is the area where we mostly
shall we start karein, sir?
Our capacity.
Yeah. So
this endeavor, Professor Ujjwal Singh, on on 5th we have the privilege, and we understand that he will have his PPT presentation and followed by interaction. So I will not take more time. Welcome, sir, and now I hand over the session to you. Thank you, sir, Dr. Mohan Kumar. Yeah.
Thank you, Dr.
An interactive session after PPT. Yeah, thank you, sir.
It's very kind of you. Dear friends, as already said by Professor Rajesh, today's colloquium's topic is, how to write a research article. And I'm sure, you are participating as a mixed group of postgraduate students and research scholars. So you all know, writing itself is a difficult task. It is not a cup of tea for everyone. Even the poets also, they have to squeeze their brain to write properly. So we are as students and the scholars, we may have to know how to simplify the writing and then how to be more closer to the best of writing. And my experience is that unless we concentrate on the writing part, we'll not be able to complete it, because we must have a plan how to write anything, even a letter also, even family, inside the family also. If you are writing a letter to your father or sister or brother or auntie or uncle, you must have some subject to write. Otherwise, nobody will write anything for fun. So we will just go through this short presentation. What is the article and what is the research article? How to write? Now, I just wish to start from the article. See, anything, if you feel a matter of interest, you can write. Anything interest. If you are interested in writing an article about your village or your town or your family or your friends, many people write. Or a child whom you see in trouble, so you can write an article on the child also. And if you see one of your close relatives have become an IAS officer, and you can write an article on him also. So article must be having a subject of interest for the writer. And what is this thing? For what you are writing? To publish it, either in journals or in magazines or in newspapers. You can see many people write in newspapers also, a short article. So one can write, anyone can write an article. And at the same time, any article written by known people, skilled people, experienced people, their article is referred by many. Today you refer as researchers, you may be referring the articles related to your topic in the journals, in website, and I think that is called the striking rate. You know, this is one of the grading of assessing the strength of a journal. This is called the striking rate. Maybe you and I, when I write, ordinary people are write means, you know, very few people will be having a striking rate. But known people are writing. Now, Natwar Singh, retired IFS officer and Minister of State also for External Affairs, he is a very good writer. And if he writes, then naturally, you know, everybody will be seeing that also. So that striking rate will be more. However, research paper or research article, in the name itself telling, you know, this is based on a study. So for that, you must have a topic. That is very important. You must have a topic. You must have why you are doing the research on it. Goal. And the goal also, it must be researchable. If you take a goal which is not researchable, you will not end your article or your study. And what is the objective of your research, which are specific objectives for a research paper, research article should be very specific. And also that is measurable. Measurable means through statistical means. Attainable, you have to complete it. And it must be closer to realistic and time bound. You know, you cannot have a research for 10 years, 15 years. Then it will not become research. Because it will become an old, like a newspaper. Today's newspaper is tomorrow's raddi. So in addition, you may have to review other published materials related to the topic. So that is, if you do all these things and prepare a paper or prepare an article, then that is called research article or research paper. Now, research articles, sometimes, you know, it is referred as empirical or primary sources. In a major, many times, you know, you have to have primary sources or collection of data. And report on original research. The research article should be based on original research. That should be done by you, not by anybody else. And they will typically include sections. Very specific sections are there. Introduction, methods, results, discussion. These are all very standard things which should be a part of research article. Now, research is to collect data from primary and secondary sources. You all know there are two sources of collecting the data. That is primary. Primary means you have to prepare standardized questionnaire or interview schedule, collect the data from the beneficiaries or from the persons who, from whom you want information related to your topic. Secondary is from the records, from any source which is not primary one. And not only that, you know, the researcher may also have some idea about his own topic. And only based on that, you cannot write an article. Because you have to ensure that apart from your own idea, your ideas must be properly supported by statistics. It is a measurable one. And it should be that the statistics also, right statistics should be used. It cannot be non-related things cannot be used. And also, you know, the research articles are normally published in renowned journals. If you see science journals, social science journals, you know, those things which carry a original research paper, not an article by someone, they won't do it. Because it is a prestige for the journal also, which is publishing such a one. Then another one is review articles. You know, apart from research article, third one is review article. What is the review article? You know, you take literature review. See, anyone has written a book, anyone has written a poem. are a group, consolidated the volume of poems, one has to review that, and that review material is a secondary source, because already the book is there, already the matter is there. So you review that and bring out another view of that articles or another view of that poems, so that, you know, it becomes an article. So this is how, you know, many times, you know, Hindi films, many of the songwriters are writing songs for the Hindi films, and subsequently these songs by a particular person is researched. It is researched. It becomes thesis. That is a secondary source. There is no primary source. So Majnu Sultana. So unka poems songs ko you can very well write. Tamil mein there is a Kannadasan karke. So Malayalam another fellow. So this is called review. So you are reviewing somebody's written matter and brings out as a report. That is called review reports. Now, research paper and research articles are pieces of writing that require critical analysis. You must be very careful, particularly research scholars think originally. Your research paper or your article, it must have a critical thinking. Inquire, not enquire. Just to see the spelling. Inquire means go into deep into the subject. You inquire and then bring out the new things about a particular thing. The Indian Railways ke bare mein 100 articles might have come, but you may be inquire into a specific aspect which nobody has brought out. That is called critical analysis. That is called inquiring into it and insight. So you not only inquire, go deep into it, and you bring the insight. So this is how, this is the new view, like that. And demonstration of some special skills from students and scientists. This is the thing. See, when you show a speciality, that becomes a research article. At the same time, research article is a paper or writing that informs people in the path-breaking research. Now, when anyone reads your research article, they must find out, my God, this person has really worked hard, really worked hard. So that is the one which is important for a research article. So that is a finding with the clinical data. Clinical data means not in the clinical side. It is actually statistical data and support to find your outcomes. Is there any difference between research article and research paper? The experts say that there is no such difference. That both are almost original documents, whether you write it as a paper or you write it as an article. Normally, when students do in the name of research, they really do the paper, but they call it as research. You know, for example, we have project report. The project report, we always say that, you know, humne research project kiya tha. So it is not actually research project. It is a paper. But scientists who do it, it is really a research, because they have lab testing. They test the whole thing. Even social scientists also, for pure science, if the lab is in the lab which is having scientific equipments, the social scientist, the lab is a society. So anything you do in a groundbreaking or pathbreaking work, bring out certain things, which is very nice. You know, I still remember I have read one article about the positive side of caste system. when I saw that material, I was really surprised, because normally caste system, we always degrade them. What is this nonsense caste basis for you are doing all these things? But there is a place in Tamil Nadu, a town where it is called Arupukottai town, where the Nadars, they are also a well group, strength group, and then there is a weaver group. So both of them, they compete to bring educational institutions in that city. If Nadar community brings a high school, then the weaver community brings, that is called Devangar. Devangar community brings school. If the Nadar school is upgraded as senior secondary, the Devangar also, they upgrade in senior secondary. And Devangar, if they open an arts college, the Nadar community will open an arts college. So Aisa Karkarke, you know, that town is, you know, it's a small town which is having a lot of schools, lot of colleges. This is beneficial not only to the community in which they belong, not only the caste people, but also in the general public. So this is the one. This is called inquiring into the positive side of a particular thing. So that is the pure art research article. So that we have to keep it in mind. Now, how to write an article? You know, how to write a research article? Students, research scholars are supposed to write articles. You know, I'll tell you, because I, as director, Indian Adult Education Association, we used to receive, or I used to see every year, students coming for field work. At the end of the field work, you have to write a note. You have to prepare a report. And I have seen 99% of the students not able to write a simple report. Many times I used to say that by in this field work, at least you should have learned how to write a report. Same way, in the same post, I have seen interns coming for 1 month. And in that 1 month, at the end of the 1 month, the intern supervisor, your assistant professor, needs a report from you. That report also, I have seen many not able to write, and they will be giving to someone else in the gate who are ready to prepare for money. That is very bad, very bad. You know, you are doing intern, you are studying an organization, you are moving with the people in the organization, and if you are not able to grasp that institution, that manpower, and who else will write? You know, if I have to write an article for you, it is very difficult for me, because it is not my original thing. It is originality is from your side and writing is my side. There is a big gap between the two. So when you write, the students and research scholars, they are supposed to write something which is called article or research article. And you have to publish it in the research public, particularly the research scholars, they have to publish it in the journal. It is part of your PhD and MPhil. So you have to see what is the journal in which you can publish. There are a number of journals, but the journals must be approved by UGC. Otherwise, you know, your writing will not be counted for your success. Then for writing an article, choice of an appropriate topic is the prime importance. When you write, if you want to write, you must have a very good topic. Very good topic. In this, I am giving you, I have even suggested a topic also. And the article can be on specific topic of general nature, if it is an article, not research article. And then you can conduct a small study on the same. If you decide to write an article, you must have a very good topic. And the topic must be a matter of interest to you or to the general public. So the topic must be very clearly written. Now I am giving you an example. See, you can choose, if you are choosing a topic, technology missions in India. India had technology missions, had with particular reference to national literacy mission. This is your topic. Technology missions in India with particular reference to national literacy mission. Now, to write this article, you need to collect information through secondary sources about technology missions. You have to choose secondary sources because technology missions are almost completed. So you have to choose the secondary sources. Now, you must know India had, you must have some knowledge. What is that? You must know that several technology missions during 80s and 90s. 80s and 90s, India had several technology missions. These technology missions came when Rajiv Gandhi was the Prime Minister and Mr. Sam Pitroda was his scientific advisor. So that time the missions came. The first technology mission was telecommunication. The telecommunication, which that time I visited that organization also, Mr. Sam Pitroda was director there. It is called the C dot, C dash dot, D-O-T. So C dot was the first one which came in. That is called a telecommunication mission. Today you are having excellent telephone system, excellent handsets. We are having pagers. These are all because of telecommunication. Why? Those days, telecommunication was going in crossbar system. Very few lines used to go in that. If you want to dial from here to Lucknow, then it will go via Kanpur and then to Lucknow. Or in between also some stations will be there. It is called the crossbar system. And today you have fiber. Fiber is there, and each fiber lines is having hundreds and thousands of small wires, and they take simultaneously one class, not only one call each. It is fiber optical. So that is the revolution this technology mission has brought in. That is called telecommunication mission. Then next, immunization mission. All of you must know that DPT, the diphtheria, polio, and whooping cough, that all the three diseases are the worst for children. And now DPT is injection plus polio is a drop. So today also polio ravivar is going on because of this immunization mission. And India has almost wiped out polio attack. Otherwise, we used to have a lot of children becoming handicapped. Now, literacy. How come that, you know, we have increased literacy after 90? So, from 90 onwards, we are increasing. If you see the documents, the total number of illiterates was more than number of literates in this country up to 81 census. In 91 census, for the first time, we have surpassed the illiteracy rate. The literates become more. And that is still continuing after 91, 2001, 2011, and now going to be 2021. Now, drinking water. Drinking water mission, the objective of this mission is to provide drinking water to them. If you see, even if you go to a village, there you can see a overhead tank. There you can see pipings. There you can see public taps. So that is actually providing protected water to the people. Otherwise, we used to take the water from tank. And tank, one side you may be taking water for drinking, another side one fellow must be taking bath, and another side the bullocks and then cows are given bath. So that type of unprotected water is not, it's a very rare now. Everywhere now we have got tap water. It is called protected water for drinking. Now oil seeds. I don't know how many of you know, the same country for 100 milligram of oil, we used to run pillar to post to get the oil. Today, you know, except human being, they are extracting oil from every seed, every seed. Oil is abundantly available. Many oil companies have come because of oil seeds production. Oil seed production has been increased because of this mission. Then dairy. Dairy, in my age, I have seen 100 milliliter of milk. We have to run between the milkman. He used to come by cycle and he will, he may have 2 liters of milk with him. He will distribute it and then he will say, baki logon ke liye, abhi aa raha hu, abhi aa raha hu, abhi aa raha hu, karke bhag jayega. So now today, the dairy mission has made Operation Flood. That mission objective is Operation Flood. Now dairy, doodh, everywhere it is available. Kitna packets chahiye? How many varieties of milk is available? Full cream, half cream, pasteurized, double pasteurized. There are so many. These are all because of technology missions. So, and technology missions, these technology missions have almost completed the development. Now, today also missions are there. It is not that missions are, technology mission is, the missions are not there. If there are missions, but they are not called the technology mission. It is only in mission mode. For your information, I am giving you few. One mission is called Namami Gange. It's a national mission for clean Ganga. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, elementary education. Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan, secondary education. Uchchatar Shiksha Abhiyan, it is higher education. National Mission for Sustainable Agriculture. National Rural Health Mission, NRHM. National Rural Livelihood Mission. E Panchayat is a vision to empower and transform rural India. Integrated Child Development Scheme. Vande Bharat Mission, you know, it brought all the flights of Air India, brought hundreds and thousands of people in the pandemic time from other countries. National e-governance plan to focus on electronic governance such as banking, land records and commercial. All have become now electronically available. So, but these are all actually not technology mission. They are mission mode. They are programs of Government of India in mission mode. Hence, your collection of data should be on the technology missions only, because your topic is on technology mission. And what are all the things you have to collect? Their need. Why technology missions came? What are the objective of that? And how it was implemented, the strategy? However, a detailed information may have to be obtained for national literacy mission, because you told technology missions, but in detailed study about the national literacy mission. So you have to, if you write this article, so you will be giving more information about the technology missions, their objectives, their implementation strategy, all those things. And national literacy mission, you will go deep into it. What is the preparation of this mission, how it was prepared, how the survey was conducted, how the illiterates were identified, and what was the first NLM strategy. The first one was done by Kottayam University, Mahatma Gandhi University. Second was the Ernakulam program. And then Kerala became illiterate. Then every district in every state started the leadership program. So this mission came to an end in 2019. They have completed, then Sakshar Bharat started. So up to 2019, you have to give the achievements of National Leadership Mission. Then your article will be a good article. Now, if your article or paper is based on a small study, it is called action research. If you are doing it based on a study, then you may have to give reasons for choosing the topic. Why you are choosing the topic? And how the study was conducted? What was the sample used? Size of the sample, collection of data, presentation in tables, how you have analyzed, how you concluded, and what is your recommendation? See, this is an article based on a small study. It is called, you can call it as an action research article. Now, Iskeliebi, I am giving you an example. For example, you wish to study about the social and economic status of cycle rickshaw pullers in Delhi who have migrated from different states of India. If you want to study, you are taking this. The topic you have chosen is social and economic status of cycle rickshaw pullers in Delhi, and then who are they? They are migrated from different states. For this, you may have to first limit the study to a particular area. Okay, Delhi is a vast area. You cannot have a study of the entire Delhi. So you may have to limit the study. How do you limit? You must know where the cycle rickshaw pullers are abundantly available, more in number, like office premises, colleges, university, railway station, metro station, etc. Then you must formulate an interview schedule. Now here also I wish to give some clarification. Interview schedule and questionnaire are always confused by our students. Even research scholars have confusion. Interview schedule is the one you have to administer. You are the one you will be using interview schedule to your selected sample and get the information. You will write it in the schedule. Questionnaire, you can give it to the person from whom you want to collect. For example, you want me to give some information, then I can write, because I am an educated person. I can understand. And people, questionnaire may only problem is, you know, if the persons are not able to understand your question properly, the answer will be completely different. But in interview schedule, because you are getting the information from the beneficiary, so you can at least mod mod kabhi question push sakte hain and get the information properly. So the collection of data will formulate the question. In the schedule, you may have to have a number of variables. Your questionnaire should have very good number of variables. The variables are the one which is going to give you a strength. Say, what is a variable? Say, age is a variable, caste is a variable, educational qualification is a variable, income is a variable. And if cycle rickshaw pullers means, no, they belong to different states, so the states are variable. So this is as many variables you get, that much will become the tables, and each table can be explained. If you don't have variables, it is really difficult to write an article. If you are writing a research article based on your own research topic, see, earlier I told that you are taking a small topic for an action research and do it. That is more on paper. Now, you are a research scholar. For a research scholar, if you are writing an article based on your research paper, research topic, then you must take some leaves from your own topic of research. When you are writing an article based on your research, you should take only from that portion of the research. Data and analyze the same to conclude so that your article comes out well. Many a times, research scholars can write more than one article on the chosen topic. You can very well write more than one article. Many research scholars bring out their thesis as a book. Unfortunately, as a editor of the Indian Journal of Adult Education, I have seen many of the research scholars could not convert their research thesis into article. The same thing happens in the book also. If the researcher thinks that whatever you have written in the PhD thesis, it can be given to a press and then made as a book, then nobody is going to see that book. Because your thesis will contain many unnecessary things. You know, that book need not have those things. If any researcher, if you wish to complete your PhD thesis, after getting the PhD, if you wish to bring out a book, then you must edit the entire thing properly. Not only language, but grammar and with the specific topics. Whether it is an article or research article or paper, there is a standard format to be followed. See, I am again telling you, whether it is an article or research article or any paper, you must have some standard procedure to be written. What is that? You must have abstract. The first one should be abstract. Again, I'm telling you, as an editor of the Indian Journal of Adult Education, even veterans also not able to write the abstract. What they do? The first paragraph of the article is written as abstract. The same thing. I used to wonder, abstract cannot be like abstract should give more of general in nature. For example, if your research is on unemployment, so you must write about employment opportunities and what is unemployment and how this unemployment in India and then how the themes are brought in for creating employment. All those things will come in abstract. Abstract must be, once a person reads the abstract, then the person need not go to the article at all. Okay, he knows what you have written. So that is called abstract. Then every article should have keywords. So you have to take it from your article. What are the keywords? You cannot write an abstract and keyword. You cannot write a keyword and then go to the article. No, you must write an article, then come to the keywords. Then introduction. See, introduction, what is that? To introduce the topic in the context. You cannot write anything or nothing to do with your topic. It must be contextual, your introduction. Then method. Describe the kind of data used. What is the data you are using it? Primary data, secondary data, and how you are collected. What is the sample size? What is the sample method you have used? Is it just culling out the data, or stratified sampling, or random sampling? All those things you must write. Then results. The results in the study may be illustrated visually using tables and figures. So you must, if you really wish to have the article to come out well, you must have more number of tables, and not all tables. You can have visuals also. You can have pie diagram. You can have bar diagram. Even in your PhD thesis also, you know, you cannot have black and white. Nowadays, itna badiya printing technology has improved. You can have at least that particular page a color page. so that the difference between one bar is understood from the another bar. Then discussion, analyze and evaluate your findings. That is called a discussion. Use your own words. Analysis, you must use your own English. Don't steal it from others. If you steal more from others, then your originality is lost. Then conclusion. What is the conclusion? Most of the people, again, I found, they are not able to write the conclusion. Conclusion is, you have to reiterate the main points and summarize in brief and clearly express the manner. Whatever you have written in the earlier paragraphs, summarize it. Very nicely you can give. Then you must give references. References is a very important part of the whole thing. The references will come whenever you see anything, taking something from other books or papers or magazines or internet or website, whatever may be. You have to immediately note down from where you have written and then what date you have noted down. So that is very important, and references can be written in a very nice form. There is a standard format which you have to follow. Then, research article, title is, must be there, abstract must be there. The title, again, you know, title, it must be a very long title. You should have a good title under. Abstract must be there, keywords must be there, introduction must be there, introduce the topic, literature review must be there, method again, describe the kind of data you have used, result, discussion, conclusion, references or bibliography, whatever may be. This is for the research article. So research article must be have, these are all the things which are used. And writing a good article quickly. If you want to write really a good article, what is to be done? You must keep it in mind, these points. What is that? Select an appropriate title and it should be lengthy and clear. You know, the topic must be lengthy and clear so that, you know, you are able to impress upon the readers that this is what you are writing. Then enumerate ideas relating to the topic. This is for you. You enumerate. You note down what are you going to write in that article. If you don't know, if you don't enumerate, you will not be able to write. That is called a template. In another word, template. What should be the first paragraph? What should be the second paragraph? What is the third paragraph? What is the fourth paragraph? Then your first draft should be lengthy. Why? Why your first draft should be lengthy? Because when you edit, you will be cutting short certain things. And long sentences may become small sentences. Sometimes the words will be deleted. So it must be lengthy. The heading of the article should be short, clear and informative. Heading means subheadings. Under, the main heading will be, title should be long. But in between the article, the small paragraphs, that must be very small, very short, very crisp. Then keep your writing in simple language. You need not go for Shakespearean English. There's no need. You have to introduce the language in your own way. What you are using in day-to-day life, that can be used. And wherever possible, you can write important points in bullets. Introduction and conclusion should be very attractive. See, you know well, in a court judgment, the operational paragraph is at the end. Any judgment, any person reading, they won't go through from first page to last page. They straight away come to the last paragraph, what is called operational paragraph. So introduction and conclusion should be attractive. After writing the article, read more than once and edit properly. So you can nowadays, because you are all lucky, because when you put the article in the computer, the computer itself says, somewhere it is giving red mark, somewhere it is giving grammar mistake, so then green mark. So based on that, you can correct it. And then so that, you know, after editing, it will become. I'll tell you, I always told my friends also in the Delhi University, when I in my age, when I write an article, I go through it at least for 7 to 8 times. Unless I am satisfied, I don't send it for publication. So that is the very most important one. And above all, you must set a timetable to complete the article and strictly follow the time schedule. So you cannot write an article for 10 months. By the time you write, the article will become again useless because the data will be old. So you must write the article with time frame. So this is what I just wanted to tell you. I hope I could explain to you to the point, and I thank all of you for your patient hearing. If you want any clarification, kindly ask.
Any question, anything to ask, please?
Yeah.
Yes. You are audible, please ask. हाँ बोलोगा मिस्टर बोलो
बोलिए रामेश्वर जी बोलिए बोलिए विच वन ना आई कुड नॉट
ये पूछ रहे हैं सर जो लिटरेचर रिव्यू करने हैं उसमें कितने करने हैं तो सर अभी बताएंगे रामेश्वर कि डिपेंड कर रहा है कि तुम एमए का डिजर्टेशन कर रहे हो एमफिल कर रहे हो पीएचडी लेवल का कर रहे हो रिसर्च आर्टिकल लिख रहे हो तो तुम शायद आर्टिकल के कॉन्टेस्ट में पूछे होगे कि एक आर्टिकल लिखने के लिए कितने आर्टिकल्स को रिव्यू या बुक्स की रिव्यू करनी चाहिए आइडियली ये पूछ रहे हैं सर रामेश्वर
या एनीवन Anybody else?
Yes, sir. Am I audible, sir?
Yeah, Lynn.
Yes, sir. Lynn speaking here.
Lynn, you are audible. Audible.
First, I was so glad that you have talks about comprehensive and insightful inputs regarding articles and research publication.
Yeah.
I was so delighted with the input, sir.
Yeah.
Coming to the question. In research articles and publication, you have mentioned the different sense and the differences and the main points that can be highlighted and they can be omitted. So my question is, how methodologies in article research paper methodologically, how are data and how will be the relevance and significant data can be given to a systematic manner, and how much methodology will be important in research writing, sir?
You know, in a research article, you are asking about references.
The methods and the approach.
You know,
methodology.
You can refer as many material as possible. The only thing is, you know, you start reproducing in their own words in the research, then the university has a problem in clearing your research. Normally what we do is much important ones, we take it in the original researcher's words. Other things, you know, you have to mend in your own language and put it in a proper way.
Okay.
So that actually, you know, that doesn't reflect the book or material in which you have referred. Say, for example, if you are taking anything from the book which I have written, now you cannot have entire material from Mohan Kumar's book. You know, that then the software clearance will not be, you will not be able to get it. They will say that many of the paragraphs have been taken from Mohan Kumar's book.
Plagiarize.
This is what I am telling. You must have your own language. simple language, whether it is PhD or article, simple language, understandable language with less of grammatical and spelling mistakes. That is more important. You know, as an adjudicator of thesis, I have seen, you know, people in very, very fashionable way, they wanted to write Shakespearean English and finally land in trouble. Simple language. And references should be limited to the most important one where you wish to reinforce your idea in some other's words. That is the thing.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
सर नमस्ते.
या बोलिए
सर. मेरे दो क्वेश्चन थे सर. पहला क्वेश्चन ये है मेरा कि क्या जो आपने फॉर्मेट बताया है रिसर्च पेपर का, सेम फॉर्मेट हिंदी में भी अप्लाई होगा, हिंदी में रिसर्च पेपर लिखने के लिए? क्योंकि कई बार सर मैंने हिंदी के काफी रिसर्च पेपर पढ़े हैं, वो इंट्रोडक्शन से स्टार्ट होते हैं, सारांश या समरी से स्टार्ट नहीं होते हैं, एब्स्ट्रैक्ट से स्टार्ट नहीं होते हैं. सेकेंड क्वेश्चन सर मेरा ये है कि जो बिब्लोग्राफी होता है, तो इंग्लिश में तो एपीएन फॉर्मेट जो हम फॉलो करते हैं, हिंदी में कई बार कई बुकों में अलग अलग तरीके से देखा, तो हिंदी का भी कोई स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्मेट है कुछ ऐसा बिब्लोग्राफी का?
नो नो, एक्चुअली यू नो एनी देयर इज अ स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्मेट नॉर्मली यू नो से फॉर एग्जांपल लिखते वक्त वी मोहन कुमार, सो कुमार मोहन वी, वेदर इट इज हिंदी और इंग्लिश, यू नो द सेम टाइप ऑफ थिंग यू हैव टू राइट. तो हिंदी में अलग से कोई लिखने का जरूरत नहीं है, द सेम फॉर्मेट यू हैव टू राइट. एंड देन द थीसिस के लिए, द एमफिल थीसिस और पीएचडी थीसिस, देयर इज अ स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्मेट टू बी यूज्ड व्हिच यू हैव टू फॉलो. And you can see other theses written in Hindi, how they have been cleared. And then if that format you are using it, there is no problem at all. English also the same thing. People used to see other theses, how it is written. You know, American way of writing and British way of writing, the references totally different. Different way of writing is there, particularly references.
जी सर, थैंक यू सर.
ओके राजेश.
हाँ, एनी क्वेश्चन? आई थिंक दिस इज नो क्वेश्चन.
दे डोंट हैव एनी क्वेश्चन.
या सर, दिस इज द बिगिनिंग कंटिन्यूअसली, एंड आई होप इन नियर फ्यूचर आल्सो व्हाट कैन बी डन दैट इन कोर्स ऑफ टाइम. They may be given some opportunity to write something, and then one by one their individual issue could be taken care of. What we see, sir, as a department, that this portion we do not stress too much how to write the report, how to write the research article. These things are very important. When sir we were handling the United Nations project on population education, they always used to say,
sir,
that there need to be a process documentation and dissemination. And we were trying, but we were not very successful. So what is happening that we have to make this aspect very seriously, and giving the students and scholars starting from master degree to research scholars to write the report and do something to begin, and then some expert advice on the individual contributions are needed. So this was just the beginning, sir, and we understand that we will continuously provide such kind of opportunities to our master and research scholars where they will get the opportunities to interface in short group, in long group, so that their research capacity, their article writing capacity can be increased, and they can contribute academically for the growth of themselves and for the growth of the department. So this is the very good beginning, sir, and you have the very vast experience. We all know, while editing the Indian Journal of Adult Education, how much efforts you were doing and editing the article so many times. A day before also, you have very seriously edited what a kind of a thing we have written in terms of the employability. And not only that, you also ask that why and for whom it is being written. Such questions and such probe was actually needed. And this you have done also when we were seriously planning and executing our master degree in lifelong learning. So, sir, will not go just to continue. I am really very thankful. Your contribution will remain continuously for our students and scholars, so that in this very important area where they have to have built their
Thank you.
Capacity in writing skills in terms of all very important. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. Thank you, scholars, students also for joining. A very, very pertinent question, sir. Thank you, sir.
All the best to students.
Thank you so much, sir.
Right, sir.
Thank you, sir.